Philippine Transportation Department eyeing to award the rehabilitation contract of Manila's main gateway as early as January next year. So far, six parties have purchased bidding documents with three new bidders. The DOTR is optimistic more entities will participate in the bidding.
We're very happy with the turnout. We had our first roadshow in Singapore, 2 days of roadshow in Singapore. This was attended by more than 200 participants. In Paris, we had 2 days of roadshow also. And those who attended in person and in online is around 50. More or less 50 interested parties. We are expecting them to participate in the bidding. And we're hoping that there will be some other interested parties who will join the bidding process.
The deadline for bid submission is on December 27. The chosen private partner will repair the Noy Aquino International Airport for 15 years, subject to an extension. This in a bid to raise the airport's capacity to at least 62 million passengers and increase its air traffic movement. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. leads the rice distribution and the launch of the Bagong Pilipinas Serbisyo Fair in Camarines Sur. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Joyce Balancho. Hi, Joyce. Good afternoon.
Yes, good afternoon, Rica. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. flew on Saturday to the province of Camarines Norte for two events that aim to provide assistance to the residents of the province. One is the launching of the Bagong Pilipinas Serbisyo Fair here at Camarines Sur Polytechnic College in the town of Nabwa. This one-stop shop event brings together around 50 programs and services of around 33 agencies of the government under one roof to improve accessibility and to speed up the delivery of government assistance to the grassroots level. Services include processing of NBL clearance and police clearances, issuances of passport, driver's license, postal ID, national ID, PSA certification, SSS, GSIS, Pag-ibig, and PhilHealth membership, among others. This event also includes the giving of livelihood, educational, social, and financial assistance from various agencies to targeted beneficiaries.
Ilan lamang po itong mga ito sa maaari ninyong i-avail sa araw na ito. Maliban po sa Serbisyo Fair, namahagi din po tayo ng ilang mga ayuda upang matulungan ang mga magsasaka. Nagbigay po ang DA, the Philippine Coconut Authority, PhilMEC, at National Dairy Authority ng mga traktor, harvester, truck, pangkarga, at iba pang kagamitan pang sakahan. Hindi rin po natin nakakalimutan ang ating mga mangingisda dahil ang BIFAR ay namigay rin ng mga fish cage package at ilang bangkang dimotor. Namigay din po ang DOH ng mga wheelchair na maaaring magamit ng ating mga senior citizen at sana ay makatulong ito sa inyong nalubos.
In another event, President Marcos also led the distribution of rice to around the 2,000 indigent beneficiaries who each will receive 25 kilograms of rice. Camarines Sur Governor Luigi Villafuerte said the rice from the local government and was subsidized by Malacañang. In his speech, Marcos said that while rice supply in the country is sufficient for the demand, something needs to be fixed in terms of its distribution. The government now, he said, is doing something to improve the value chain and to make sure that there is no unnecessary increase of the price of rice in the market. Rica.
Thank you so much, Joyce Balancho, reporting live from Camarines Sur. A bill seeking to categorize acts of market abuse of agriculture and fishery commodities as economic sabotage has made its way to the plenary of the House of Representatives. These acts include large-scale hoarding, profiteering, and cartelizing. The proposed measure also aims to increase the minimum period of imprisonment from 12 years to a minimum of 20 years and the monetary fine to 6 times the fair market value of commodities. It also seeks to lower the threshold for considering smuggling as large scale from the existing 10 million pesos to only 1 million pesos. Some good news for motorists. An oil price rollback looms next week following an 11-week streak of fuel price hikes. Latest estimates show a liter of diesel and gasoline may be cheaper by up to 40 centavos. As for kerosene, prices may be slashed by as much as 70 centavos. Veteran Philippine politician Bayani Fernando died Friday after a fatal fall from the roof of his house. He was 77. The former Marikina City Mayor and Congressman had also previously served as chairman of the Metro Manila Development Authority, or MMDA. The MMDA praised Fernando as someone who used scientific and practical approaches to solve the problems of Metro Manila. He led the agency from 2002 to 2009. Fernando served 3 terms as mayor of Marikina before becoming district representative from 2016 to 2022. The Philippines eyeing to file a new complaint against China over its alleged coral harvesting in the West Philippine Sea. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says the government will soon discuss possible complaints that will be filed before the arbitral court. In 2016, the Hague-based court ruled in favor of Manila and invalidated Beijing's sweeping claims over Philippine waters.
Whether or not it is our territory, but it is within our vicinity, already gives us a moral responsibility to pursue the destruction of the environment as a task for humanity, for the good of humanity. It can be the arbitral court again. It is possible that we will file it before the arbitral court.
The fresh tension stems from the recovery of massive coral, from the discovery rather, of massive coral damage in Rosal Reef, which Philippine authorities blame on China. But Beijing downplays the incident, saying Manila is just creating political drama over the issue. A marine expert earlier warned the country was losing around 33 billion pesos annually from the damaged reefs. The U.S., Philippines, and Japan hold a trilateral meeting in New York on the sidelines of the U.N. General Assembly High-Level Week. According to the U.S. State Department, Secretary of State Antony Blinken, Philippine Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo, and Japanese Foreign Minister Kamikawa Yoko reaffirmed their commitment to promoting peace and stability in the South and East China Seas and committed to uphold values for a free and open Indo-Pacific region. They also discussed ways to support economic resiliency and enhance trilateral cooperation on several issues such as security and the digital economy. Vietnam vows to ensure peace and security in the South China Sea in accordance with international law. Its Prime Minister Pham Minh Chinh made that commitment during a speech at the United Nations General Assembly in New York. He said Vietnam will continue to team up with other economies to make good on that promise.
We wish to reaffirm our commitment to working with other countries within and outside the region to safeguard peace, stability, security, safety, and freedom of navigation in the South China Sea in accordance with international law and the 1982 United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea. It is also necessary to exercise restraint and refrain from unilateral actions and arrest disputes and differences by peaceful means, including diplomatic and legal processes.
State volcanologists warn the fog from Taal volcano could last for a long time. FIVOLCS made this remark following continuous sulfur dioxide emission from the volcano. Some residents in Batangas have reported difficulties in breathing. The provincial government also mulls declaring a state of emergency due to the thick fog.
We will see if there is a need to declare a state of emergency in the province of Batangas upang magamit ng ating local government units ang kanilang mga disaster and emergency funds for this purpose. Ito'y pag-aaralan pa lamang at kung ano man ang magiging recommendation ng iba't ibang ahensya ng gobyerno from national government agencies to provincial government offices, yun po ang aming pangangalagaan.
The volcano is currently under alert level 1, but it has been emitting over 1,000 tons of sulfur dioxide daily since 2021. FIVOLCS also warns of possible acid rain due to volcanic smog.
It would probably take several years bago po ito bago totally mawala yung sulfur dioxide. Kasi as long as the volcano is spewing out sulfur dioxide, the threat of what is always there. It will always be a recurring threat. So we're telling people living around the Taal volcano to always be prepared. Yung sulfur dioxide po kasi is acidic. And kapag umulan, pwede pong magkaroon ng acid rain. Yung acid rain, ang magiging problema ito yung long term. Halimbawa, yung bubong natin, made of galvanized iron, makukorrode. Yung sasakyan natin, makukorrode din. Pero kapag long-term exposure, yung mga dahon sa halaman, pwedeng masunog at saka nakaka-irritating sa balat natin.
Let's now get an update on the situation in Taal. We have on the line ABS-CBN correspondent Jose Carretero. Jose, good afternoon. What can you tell us?
Good afternoon, Rica. The Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology, or PHIVOLCS, has not recorded VAG around Taal volcano today. PHIVOLCS Director Teresito Bacolcol said Taal volcano can be clearly seen this morning from their station in Batangas. He said Taal volcano is visible today in some parts of Batangas compared to yesterday, where some areas in Batangas were almost zero visibility due to the thick VAG. Meanwhile, PHIVOLCS said Taal volcano emitted 2,730 tons sulfur dioxide yesterday. This is lower compared to the more than 4,000 metric tons of sulfur emission the previous day. The volcano, Rica, remains at alert level 1. The Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office, on the other hand, is continuously monitoring the areas still affected by VAG. Dr. Amor Calayan, the head of Batangas PDRMO, said parts of San Nicolas, Batangas experienced heavy VAG this morning. But he said they did not receive reports today in some areas who have been previously affected by VAG. In People's Park in Tagaytay City, some business owners said they were affected due to limited numbers of tourists. Some vendors said fewer tourists are visiting the People's Park due to fear from VAG. Rica.
Thank you so much, Jose Carretero, reporting live.